Hey guys, thanks for clicking on the video. We're out here at a spot I've been once before. I was hoping to do a bit of fishing, but I'm here for an overnighter. Got everything I need in the backpack. Water levels are a bit lower, or quite a lot lower than last time I was out here. So I don't know how the fishing would go, but can catch freshwater barra, jungle perch, sooty grunters and that here. So you never know your luck, but I'm just out here to relax anyway, set up camp. Got the dog out here, he's loving it, and do a bit of cooking on the fire and, you know, just enjoy it. Enjoy the outdoors. So thanks again for watching, and we'll enjoy the video. Cheers. Oh, you stay busy when you're out bush. There's always something to do. I've whipped up a little fork with a pot hanger here over the fire. Pro-tuned the fireplace, got some rock bottoms, nice big back wall. Got the pot hanger as you see. Bloody chopped up heaps of firewood now. It's solid as stuff here. A fair bit of kindling. Heap of sort of, you know, thumb size stuff, wrist size, and some really hard redwood logs that'll keep me going. Yeah, I was bloody just cruising along the creek there, took the dog for a swim. But yeah, just busy. Just gonna relax, haven't eaten yet. I should get something on the go. I made a bloody spatula. just something to do. I've bought eggs for the morning and I realise I don't have anything to flip them with, so this can be my cooking utensil. They give me something to do for 10 minutes. So yeah, just been busy. The weather's holding off, but it doesn't look flash. But anyway, it's all good. It's all good. Check it out. He's buggered. He's been going flat out. But yeah, camp's come along nice. It's just relax time now. So, gonna get the rod and go for a flick late afternoon, just before dinner. So, but I've walked the creek. I haven't seen any fish, and it'd be a quarter of the depth from last time I was here. So, need them bit deeper pools to hold the fish, but there's still a slight run to it, so you never know. Anyway, sweet. Yeah, so I've got this new water bottle here. It's Be Free, that's the brand of it. I had a little go with it just before, just to check it out, and it's awesome. I've done my research on them. Because a lot of these sort of, you know, filter and water bottle in one have got a real slow flow rate, and you're just like trying to suck a bloody golf ball through a garden hose type effect. But this thing, man, it lives up to its name, eh? It just flows through. So I've got it off that Wild Earth site. Like, they sell a lot of really good camping and hiking gear, especially, you know, your worldwide sort of gear. You're not restricted to just what the Aussies are selling or whatever. Yeah, I picked this spot. Obviously, the water's flowing here. Crystal clear water, so it should be good, but I just like the filter anyway. Like, look at that. She pumps out. Oh, it tastes good too. Happy with that. That's an awesome little buy, that one. Be Free. I suppose that's the brand there. Catterton. Designed in California. There you go. Anyway, that's enough water. Got the cooking water. And I can just come down and top that up, or I can pour this into here and drink it like that. You know what I mean? Whatever. But that's actually quite cool out of there, so I'll probably just use this for drinking and come down and use that for cooking water. But that there, that packs up into this tiny little bag here. Hydration pack. So it's good for the packs. Anyway, sweet as. 8 pound line. And I think I got 10 pound leader. So we'll just rig that up. FG knot. So hard fit. I'm used to rigging up for GTs and stuff. I don't like my chances of catching a fish, but I don't want to pepper the waters like the wrong middle of the day. I want to wait till the Savo just in case there is something there, because these jungle perch and that, they spook so easily. So patience. fiddly. Do the loop knot so the lure works freely. That's a lively lure. Bomber 13A. I put new little hooks on it, so nothing worse than losing a fish because of your gear. Oh, it shits you. Oh man, what a mission. I just hiked about a couple of K up that creek. It was so shallow. I found a few little deep spots. Couldn't crystal clear water. You can see the fish if they're there. I saw three little jungle perch the size of my palm. Ridiculous, but anyway. Very scenic walk. Like, it was just beautiful. So it was good to explore because I've been here before and I didn't do that. So that was good. But yeah, I risked the wet boots and wet pants for a fish and I've just been left with wet pants and wet boots. So that sucks. Anyway, what a mission. ladies and gentlemen, this is looking good. I'm happy with this one. Just got a burly big head from Burling Brewing Co. No carb lager. Oh. Oh. Oh, that's delicious. I've outdone myself here, I think. Oh, this is incredible. This is better than I ate at home. Sorry, babe. Anyway, I'm gonna hook into this. Sorry to make you watch me eat. Got to be a 5 out of 5, mate, for sure. Delicious. That's it from me, guys. Just gonna chill by the fire and relax, dry my boots off nicely. So yeah, beautiful night, quite windy, but it's all good. So yeah, it's gonna relax and we'll see you in the morning. Sweet. Thank you. Oh, good morning. Had a bloody awesome sleep. Sort of didn't get up till about 10 to 7 or something, because the, you know, there was no getting sunrise shots or anything like that. So in a big valley here, you know, it looks the same time of day all day. We just got back from a swim, didn't we, mate? You stink. A bit fresh. I couldn't film that, the old nudie run, so I don't think the likes of me would get too much hits doing that sort of stuff. So, but yeah, nah, bit of a sleep in, 10 to 7. Time to get a coffee on the go and some brekkie. Feel refreshed after that swim though, geez, feels good. Yeah, I think we might get a coffee on, mate. Hey? Alright, calm down. Yeah, anyway, good morning. We'll just wait for that to burn down and then we'll start cooking brekkie. Got the tent and all that packed up, so brekkie, pack the tarp up, load the bag, hit the road. Thank you. right, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Yeah, just want to say thank you to sort of everyone that subscribed and liked and dropped comments. Lucky, that water. I'll get in the car soon. Yeah, thanks very much. I'm pushing 800 now, so we'll get to that 1,000 mark. Not that anything's going to change, you know, I'm only doing what I do anyway, so it's all good. But yeah, thank you very much. And a special thank you to Simon from Dawn Mowers in Melbourne, down there. Yeah, what a top bloke. He specified he didn't want a plug or anything like that, but he's a big dealership of the Gransfors Bruk axes, and he's got a really good knife collection there too. He was really kind to send us up a couple of axes, like a little hatchet and a forest axe. So thanks very much, Simon. Much appreciated. I've had good fun using it, and as you would know, quite a few videos now, so bloody really enjoying it. So thanks again, Simon. You're a legend, mate, and it's been a pleasure talking to you on the phone and that. You're a top bloke. But anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Cheers. See you, Lucky. Let's go.